Hello, and welcome to the Commission's Corner. I'm Fort Bend County Commissioner Grady Prestige. We really enjoy doing this video editorial and the electronic newsletter that comes with it. One of the reasons we had to do it was because we found that it was a situation where people had a lack of information about local issues. Some parts of Fort Bend County are fortunate to have a daily paper, the Fort Bend Herald. It's a daily paper where you can find out information about what's going on in their community. Rosenberg bans political use of city seal. The story about remembering fallen heroes with a memorial for officers killed in line of duty. Story about the George Moore Library hosting a team trivia event. City Council might fight to deny CenterPoint a rate increase. Hundreds cast early votes in city and ISD races. Historic downtown ready for May. A fallen state representative about his career. The Rosenberg Development Authority is meeting to discuss parks and the future of Rosenberg. The acute care center at Oak Bend Hospital is being funded by the Jack and Billy Went Foundation. All these are local issues that are of great importance to the people who live in the portion of the county that's served by this paper. Unfortunately, every part of the county isn't fortunate to have a daily paper. In fact, daily papers are on the decline in this country. And to try to make up for that void that's going to be created, we get our information from a lot of different areas. We get it from the internet, all the social media outlets. With that, you can't tell whether or not it's authentic, something made up, or just somebody's opinion. And if you really dig deep, there's very little actual news in social media. So the Precinct 2 newsletter started off as a tabloid newspaper that we produce quarterly. And we tried to go and find stories, just like the ones you see in the Fort Bend Herald, that you would normally see from getting the Houston Chronicle. And this happened at a time when social media, well, the internet didn't even exist. But as times changed and things evolved, that became less and less practical and affordable to do a printed newspaper that was mailed out to all the constituents. As the population grew, the numbers of circulation grew, the cost of postage went up, cost of printing went up, and it became impractical to do. So we went and followed the route that a lot of people are taking and doing an electronic newsletter. So it's our job moving forward to make sure that we can replicate the kinds of stories you see in these local papers. Good stories that affect the communities that they serve. And that's a challenge. So we've asked a lot of times in our newsletter that if you have any stories that are real news stories that you think need to be shared with your community, send it to us. There's a link in the newsletter for that, and we'd appreciate and welcome it. We can't print everything you send us, and we're certainly going to scrutinize it to make sure that it's not self-serving and that it really serves a community purpose. With that, we'll hope you continue to follow the Precinct 2 newsletter. We enjoy doing it, and I get a great response from out in the community, and it looks like this is a project that will keep going on for many years to come. That's it for this edition of the Commission's Corner. We'll see you next time.